Guys, nice to be back tomorrow. How does it feel after all this time going into the season as defending champions?
Just exciting. I can't wait for tomorrow. It almost feels like an extended celebration. So proud that we're the first ones to do a flag day, as we call it here. And just really can't wait to be walking out of Celtic Park again for the occasion that it's going to be. Like I say, I feel like it's an extended celebration with the fans, which is important. Just looking forward to it.
You've just come back from Sweden and the camp and the friendlies there. What was the main sort of learning for you in terms of the team, but also as captain, with that kind of bonding experience and the football that you play?
Main kind of learning is, I think, still just learning to play with new players who are obviously joining us for the first time in a competitive match tomorrow. Getting to know each other on and off the pitch, which I think is really important, and I think is one of the things that helped us be really successful last year. So a really important week away with everybody before the season starts. And like I say, just I think the key learning is how we play together on the pitch, how we play, them fitting into our system, us adapting to their strengths, little differences from players that we had last year and stuff like that, and just really making sure that we're ready to go from tomorrow, because there's no easy game, and we're going in with absolutely no complacency. Yeah, we're champions, but we have a job to do, and it starts in 24 hours.
Yeah. You mentioned there the new players. The squad depth feels really good, really even going into this season, and obviously there was a very steady back line last season with the back three. There are maybe a few more players in the mix now. Does that feel, in terms of having options, and how do you see yourself fitting into that, and does that maybe take the pressure off a bit?
Depending on the way you look at it, it might take pressure off, but you could also flip it and say that it's going to make us really, really competitive all over the park, because we've got places to play for, and so the pressure is maybe on rather than off. But I think it's a healthy situation to be in, because all it's going to make sure we do is that we perform to our best, both in training and in games every single week, to try and make sure Elena's got a headache every Friday night picking the team for the weekend, because we all deserve to play. Come the end of the season, it's really important to have the depth, because it's a really stressful and intense run-in, but it'll hopefully make sure that from the very start we're all playing to the best of our ability, because if we don't, then there's 100% somebody sitting on the bench that will steal your spot.
Mm-hmm. And what's your message to the fans ahead of tomorrow?
I think we have to enjoy tomorrow. We'll do our very best to be the best version of ourselves and put on a performance that you can enjoy, but we also have to enjoy it. Like I said earlier on, it is the first flag day in the women's game. We created history on the last day of the season, probably given the fact we did it in the 89th minute. It potentially hadn't set in that we'd done it when we were enjoying ourselves after the game. So tomorrow's a real chance to come and, like I say, hopefully watch some good football, but look back to what we did last year and enjoy what we did in a much less stressful environment, because I'm pretty sure a lot of them felt stressed on the last day of the season before we scored that goal in the 89th minute.
Yeah. Elena, for you, the Sweden games and the trip, what was your biggest takeaways as a coach? What did you come back with?
I would say different things. Obviously, I think what Kelly just said about the group and the strength of the group last season, how close we were to each other, that's something that we need to keep building on and make sure that we have the same cohesive group like we had last season, if not stronger. I think that was a great thing to be in like a part of. But for me, I think the biggest things that I take with me is obviously what we do domestically is one thing, but we also need to know that there's other teams out in Europe that are strong. So how can we come to Scotland, and how can we make sure that every training is the best training that we can do, so we progress as a team, so we're ready for Europe. And I think that was something that I wanted the girls to see and experience, is that we're the best in Scotland, but there's other teams in Europe that are doing really well. And I think that was the best thing I could give the girls, is that experience and that understanding that, just because we're champions and we're the best
team in Scotland doesn't mean that we're the best out in Europe. And that's something that I feel like we should just be reminded sometimes, like when we go to training, is like we don't have only domestically to think about, we also want to challenge out in Europe.
Talking about the game tomorrow, Dundee United, obviously the first game of the season, there's a lot of changes that happen over the summer. Do you know what to expect from them, and what you tell the team in terms of the expectations for them?
No, obviously I have a, you know, I have staff members that have their roles and their responsibility to make sure that the opposition analysis is ready. I always focus more on ourselves, so the girls know that we always have things that we need to be aware of and things that we need to exploit, but the main focus will always be us. Always be us. And that's something that we've been talking about today as well, is Celtic, like how we play is about dominating, and that's something that we are going to go through every single day ahead of us.
And in terms of the first starting 11, what is the state of the squad in terms of any injury concerns, any players that we won't expect to see involved tomorrow?
We have right now, I think, 4 players that are not in the squad. And that is Chloe Logan, Nat Ross, or Natalie Ross. And then we have Amy Richardson and Kate Lefersky. So the good news is obviously Hannah Kern is back and Luana is back. So that's something that we've been seeing since during preseason, that they've been adapting and they've been getting their minutes and are back in the squad again.
Yet, how was pre-season? Men's team stayed together pre-season in a very success. For you, both of you, what do you feel? You had a good pre-season or stayed together in Sweden or Europe?
Players first.
The pre-season has been really good. A little bit different for us because there's an international camp that almost gets in the way, but that makes the trip away even more important, because what you lose with a couple of players being away, you obviously get back through travelling together as a group and spending 24 hours a day together. We've played hard competition, which is important. You know, we went down and played against Everton, and it was a successful outing. We, you know, challenging yourselves against players who play in the best league, one of the best leagues in the world, but certainly the best league in the UK. And then obviously over to Sweden, where we played 2 really good opponents, and you know, we tried things that we want to try, and when it doesn't work, we can learn, reflect, and we're doing it in a safe environment where the games don't have any pressure. So pre-season's been good. It's been hard. The girls will have felt it in their legs, but we've made it to the end, and I think the occasion tomorrow is what the squad deserves after putting in the miles for the last few weeks.
I think she gave you a perfect answer.
Did you have some quarrel or different misunderstanding or only success pre-season, never quarrel?
No, obviously, like, I think it depends how you look at it. Like, obviously, we have situation where we are not really happy with, but that's something we learn from. So that's the meaning of success, is like we do mistakes and we learn from it and then we correct it and then that mistake doesn't happen again, hopefully. So that's something that we see as a success.
And just for Kelly, first of all, you're Celtic captain for another year. Just how does that feel?
I think I get prouder every season that to lead the squad. I think, especially for the past 4-5 years, when since we went professional, leading the team out stronger and stronger and stronger every year, and obviously this year leading them out as defending champions is something that I'd probably never expected before the last couple of years. It's a massive honour. I don't really have the words for it. It's a massive club. I love representing them on and off the pitch, and to, you know, like I say, to lead a group of girls that you genuinely like as people before the fact that you absolutely love playing with them as professionals, it means a lot.
You've had a great career, but where would you rank the moment of, you know, being able to walk out on flag day?
Well, the only thing that would top it was lifting the trophy above my head. Like I say it all the time, but in my entire career at Celtic, I've watched the men do it so often. I've probably been at almost every flag day. But the one just there is probably one of the first ones that I have missed. So, you know, I've watched them do it so many times. I've watched them lift trophies so often. And to be doing it, you know, for this club tomorrow, just, I just can't wait. It's just amazing.
I promised her that she will do it. Do you remember?
Yeah, she actually did. When you first came in?
Yeah.
Yeah, she did. She's lived up to it.
Just for Elena, how happy does it make you, you know, that your team are going to get the chance to start their defence of the league title at Celtic Park?
I mean, like, it. I think the girls know how much it meant to me when we left that trophy last season. And I've also, like, coming to the conclusion, like, you know, I celebrated that evening and then I just moved on thinking about how to prepare them to do it again. Because that's just who I am. I try to enjoy it, but my thoughts are always like, how can we improve? How can we get better? And that's something that I feel within this year's squad, is that I really feel like there's competition in every position. And I think that the girl thinks the same. And that's something that is going to make us even stronger. And hopefully, you know, it starts tomorrow. Like, I'm just so excited to go out there. The girls get what they deserve. And then obviously it's all about starting the season well and do what we're good at. And that's playing very good football.
And just looking at the squad as a whole then, are you really, really happy with the amount of players you have in it right now for each position?
Yeah, we have two players in each position and then we have three players in another position. So it's pretty intense. And like Kelly is saying, you know, it's not easy for me to take out a squad this season. It's been a lot of talks within the staff. I have new members in the staff as well that are challenging me, and we do everything together. So I feel like we have different opinions, and that's something that, you know, I really, really like, because we look at things differently. And I think with tomorrow's squad, hopefully we get out exactly what I seen in front of me.